ready to start building the best soda can, airplanes? Let me start by asking you this question. Which soda can, airplane looks the best? This plane here? Built out of Coca-Cola cans? Or this one? Built by the team at Soda Can, Models? If you said the second one, then keep watching. We're about to show you how to up your game. Building soda can, airplanes. By the end of this video, you'll know everything you need to start building like the pros. So stay tuned. First, let's ask what does, and what doesn't, make a good soda can, airplane. First, stop using a whole can for the aircraft fuselage. It doesn't look natural. And there are better ways to make a realistic can. Fuselage for your airplanes.
Look at how we made the fuselage for this Corsair. We used 4 cans. See how realistic it looks? So why do it from one, when the results are far better with this method? Next, stop using radio control plane parts and home improvement store hardware. This plane could have been so much more had it opted for another method. Wheels and propellers can be easily produced out of can. Check out this Fokker tri-plane. See how we made our own wheels out of can and some craft foam. These wheels, while maybe not as fancy as plastic or metal ones, give this plane a classic look that can't be replicated with plastic plane parts. And how about this propeller crafted out of A&W root beer cans? See how we use the wood grain pattern to simulate a classic World War I propeller? Heck, it even spins too. Much better than opting for radio control plane parts, don't you think? Next, check out our P-40 Warhawk. From Sky Captain and the World of Tomorrow. It's an amazing soda can, model plane. Isn't it? Again, look at how we produced a working 3-bladed propeller and spinner. It really gives this plane an added touch that radio control plane parts can't replicate. And here's our can, wheels. Rolled out of black cans with a silver wheel hub. Much better, isn't it? And we even added the tail wheel for some added detail. Nice touch, isn't it? Having access to a 3D printer, like an Ender 3 Pro, can be an invaluable tool. Here are some examples of what you can print using an Ender 3 Pro 3D printer. As you can see from these examples, we can print nearly every type of propeller, from standard light aircraft to multiple types of 3- and 4-bladed propellers and spinners found on World War II planes. Don't think you can make a proper nose cone? We can also print nose cones for modern jets such as these for the F-4 Phantom II and the F-14 Tomcat. Need a better alternative to radio control airplane wheels? Try 3D printing them instead. These are a better alternative, since they can easily be printed and painted to match whatever plane you are working on. Another critical component of a good soda can, airplane, is a decent-looking canopy. While some make these out of dish soap containers or plastic soda bottles, we think we found a better way. Our first method is using a combination of clear vinyl and can to produce a realistic and clear see-through canopy that almost looks like the real thing. Check out our P-40 Warhawk. See how we created a slick-looking canopy? Much better than soda bottles or dish soap containers, isn't it? Next, check out this F-4 Phantom. This is another plane that just wouldn't look right if the canopy didn't look like the real thing. Clear vinyl is easy to work with and is a cheap and viable alternative for making soda can, airplane canopies. This one looks pretty slick too, but there's another way to make canopies. And what's the other way? Using can, of course. Sometimes, using clear vinyl just isn't practical. So in cases like this, MiG 21 fighter jet, combining silver and blue can, does the trick. So how did we do this? First we built the silver canopy and aircraft spine structure, then we cut out windows out of Pepsi cans, and glued them into position. Over top. Again, much better than soda bottles, or dish soap containers. One of the most common questions we get asked is, what tools and supplies are required to build soda can airplanes like these, and what glue do you recommend? Our glue of choice, and the brand we swear by, is Loctite. We prefer the super glue gel, because it allows just enough time to place parts before the glue sets. Loctite can be found at most grocery, hardware, and hobby stores, and is perfect for working with cans. You'll also notice that we have a bottle of Goof Off. This is their Pro Strength Super Glue Remover. This is an essential product when working with super glue and cans. If you have worked with these materials for long enough, you know that it's impossible to keep from getting glue on the can materials. Goof Off easily removes super glue residue, and we recommend it if you're going to work with cans for any amount of time. It is an essential tool. Probably the most important tool you will need is a good pair of 5-inch precision scissors. We prefer 5-inch scissors because it allows us to easily make turns and cut curves, which is common if you are going to be building soda can airplanes. These are two sets of stainless steel 5-inch scissors we purchased off of Amazon for under $10 a pair. You will need to find a brand and keep them readily in your toolbox, as you will go through them often. Other tools you will need include ultra-fine permanent markers for tracing your parts onto cans, a good stainless steel ruler for making folds and bends, and multiple sizes of hobby blades. The smaller blades will be used for cutting out small details, such as canopies, while the larger blade will be essential for making precise cuts in the fuselage and other parts. Last but not least, you will need a reliable rolling tool, such as a wooden dowel. This will be an essential tool for rounding wings and shaping the wings and fuselage of your soda can airplanes. You will also need a good set of needle nose pliers for holding glued parts together, and some nail files for sanding rough edges. Another essential material we use is aluminum sheeting, or flashing as it is also known. This can be found in most hardware stores, or anywhere that roofing materials are sold. We use this material for reinforcing and strengthening control surfaces and parts of the fuselage, like intakes and base pieces. We use the thinnest gauge available so that it still has some flexibility. This is an essential part of our wing structure, as it prevents dents and wrinkles in the can material. One of the most essential materials we use is craft foam, or EVA foam as it is also known. This can be found in most hobby, craft, or online retailers, such as Amazon. We use this material to give our wings and control surfaces definition. Flat wings and control surfaces don't look natural, and this craft foam goes a long way towards giving our wings and control surfaces depth. It is also beneficial because it also sticks to can material and adheres very well. This makes it essential as a gluing surface for gluing wings and control surfaces to the fuselage. While cardboard will work, in our opinion, craft foam is a better alternative. This brings us to one of the materials we've mentioned in passing when talking about the importance of making good canopies for our airplane models. Clear vinyl is an essential tool for canopies. Again, it can be found at most hobby, craft, and online retailers in varying thicknesses. As you can see, we prefer a decent thickness that still gives us some flexibility to roll and create canopies of varying sizes and shapes. It can also be used for windows, like on our P40 Warhawk model. In our opinion, it is the best alternative to using soda bottles, soap containers, or any other piece of plastic for creating and making canopies for aircraft. So what are some key takeaways from this video? first, rolling your own fuselage is easy to learn and it looks better than just using a single can. Second, wings with staples or cardboard in them don't look good. Use aluminum sheeting and craft foam in all of your control surfaces to give them added depth and make them sturdier. Third, a lazy canopy can kill your soda can, airplane. Use clear vinyl combined with can, or just use different colored can, like we showed with our MiG-21, to make better canopies. And finally, make your own nose cones and propellers, or as a last resort, 3D print and paint them to match instead. All of these techniques will go a long way to helping you make better soda can airplanes. So, in conclusion, if you want to take your soda can airplanes to the next level, watch our tutorial videos and learn the techniques we've talked about during this video. Then when you're ready, visit us at sodacanmodels.com and pick out one of our do-it-yourself soda can model plans and start building. It's that easy. If you want to build soda can airplanes like these, then you need to stop and ask yourself, isn't it time to stop putting wings on cans and start building soda can airplanes instead? We think the answer is pretty clear.